On this episode of Undercover Boss, the Chief Executive Officer of the National Collegiate Athletic Association, also known as the NCAA, will be going undercover and participating in sporting events with young, gifted college athletes throughout the country. Meet the CEO of the NCAA, Mark Emmert. The fifth Chief Executive Officer of this organization, he assumed his duties of CEO on November 1st, 2010. Dr. Emmert has been faithfully married to his beautiful wife, Delaine, for more than 30 years, and together have two grown children, Stephen and Jennifer. Mark Emmert ascended into the college sports world from the University of Washington, where he held the honor of being the president for 6 years. Before his time at the University of Washington, Emmert was chancellor at Louisiana State University for 6 years. As the chief executive officer of the NCAA, Dr. Emmert has faced many controversial subjects. Recently, there's been a controversy in the college athletic programs as to whether college athletes should be paid or not. Mark Emmert has made very controversial decisions involving cases where student athletes have received compensation for their time playing. One of them involved a young Turkish basketball player who wished to come into the United States and play basketball at the University of Kentucky. Ian Cantor was ruled ineligible because he had taken money to play basketball as a high schooler in Turkey before he came to the United States. Because he took the money, Emmert ruled Ian Cantor ineligible to play basketball at the University of Kentucky and essentially ruined his college career by saying he had violated amateur status. Today, Mark Emmert is going to be secretly walking the grounds of the best university ever to have been created on this fine country, also known as the University of Kentucky. The University of Kentucky has a strong athletic presence throughout the Southeastern Conference. In not only their 8 national championships in college basketball, they also have a strong women's basketball program, along with smaller programs such as soccer and baseball. Mark Emmert is going to be going undercover and pretending to be filming a new reality television show about the day in the life of a college athlete. For this position, Mark is going to be participating in practice with the Wildcats men's basketball team as well as the Wildcats women's varsity soccer program. The university has a growing concern to pay their college athletes, so Mark is going to be going undercover in order to better understand the average time a college player spends with their sport and better determine whether they should be paid or not.
Hey guys, I'm Mark. I'm going to be going undercover today using the name Doug. It's for a reality TV show, and it's about a day in the life of a college athlete.
Thank you. 3 hours, you know, to perfect my game, get ready for the draft.
Yeah, man.
It's tough, you know.
Put a lot of work into it.
Yeah. Try to run these drills, you know, perfect my craft and stuff, you know. Regular stuff, you know.
You want to get a flight to you after this?
Yeah, we can, man. Where are you trying to go?
Might sound like 7 tonight. Work.
You gonna pay?
Hopefully we can split it 50-50.
Man, I am broke. I have no money.
Really?
Yeah, man. Being a college athlete, man, you know, all these perks going to it, I'm like, I'm broke right now, man. You know? Have no money. You know? Need money to put gas in my car. I have no money for that. You know? I gotta ask my coach for stuff. But yeah, man, it's just hard out here, man. Everybody knows your name, but you don't have $5 in your pocket and stuff, you know.
So what about scholarship? Is my school giving you a huge bit?
Yeah, but you know, it's like room and board, you know, tuition, food, you know, all the average stuff. But like, I still gotta do a lot of stuff. Like, I still gotta buy like food in my dorm and stuff. You know, like, I still gotta, like, if I want to go out to eat and stuff, or like go out for pizza, I still gotta pay for it myself. You know? Like, all the other stuff is good, but like, I need pocket money. You know what I mean? Be able to go out with friends and stuff, go out to movies and stuff.
Living on a budget.
Yeah, man. I feel it's hard.
All right, you want to get back in there?
Yeah, man. Just got scrubbing.
Nice to meet you.
Hope I see you again, man.
Yep, best of luck
next time. I'm gonna break your ankle.
Alright.
Alright, see you later. Good?
Hey guys. Just got done with my interview with Nerlens, and now I'm at the soccer fields. Apparently, I'm going to go undercover again with some girl named Alex. She's on the soccer team. And wish me luck.
Hey, Alex.
Yeah?
Hi, I'm Doug. Nice to meet you.
Alex, nice to meet you.
I'm from the reality TV show.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, I heard about you. Are you ready for some soccer fun?
Yeah, I'm just getting ready to just get done with it and see what you got.
Awesome. Well, come along. I'll show you.
All right,
so we're going to do suicide.
Yep.
Get warmed up. We're going to go to this first tree and then back, and the second tree and then back, and the first tree again and back.
Okay?
Ready? Make sure you touch the ground.
Yep.
Set? Go. Ready for some touches on the ball?
Yep.
We're just gonna do a simple pass drill. One touch, pass it back. Good job. So you said you were with Nerlens?
Yep.
How was that?
It went fine, pretty good.
Big guy on campus?
Yeah, it was nice to just experience that. Big guy.
I wish I could be the big guy on campus.
It has its purpose. He was talking about a lot of, actually, struggling with his funds and finding money to spend on food and everything.
Nerlens?
Yeah.
Huh. I wouldn't expect that with his scholarship.
I know, that's what I thought too.
Kind of thinks that the basketball players get better scholarships than most of us.
Yeah. How's it been with your funds? Have you had a scholarship at all?
It's been kind of rough, but no one really looks at soccer players to bring in any revenue, so. Alright, you ready for a sprint?
Yeah, let's do it.
First tree and back, ready? Go. Ready? time for a water break?
Yes.
So, Alex, how long have you been playing soccer?
Well, I've been playing soccer since I was 3. In the little tots league, you know, being a boss.
I did that, but quickly found that was not even up to my codes in soccer.
So oh, you aren't too bad. Just some touches.
How do you enjoy it, though? Do you like it?
I love soccer. It's honestly my life. Eat, breathe, sleep, everything. All I think about is soccer.
How's it impacted you being a woman in college sports?
I mean, honestly, it's kind of hard being a woman. I mean, you don't really see women's sports up on TV. You really don't have the fan base that you do for guys. And it's hard to get people to respect a woman's sport over a guy's sport. But, I mean, we're doing the best that we can and we're trying. Actually, I'm pretty sure that there's a law or a bill that's been passed a while ago called Title IX that allows it so that guys and girls, there can't be sexism in college sports.
Okay. Can you explain that a little to more of our viewers?
Basically, what Title IX is, it was passed back in 1972, and long story short, it just makes it so that guys' sports and women's sports are equal. You can't have more guy scholarships out there than girl scholarships. You can't have more benefits going towards guys than girls, which is one of the main reasons that, you know, college athletes aren't paid. But I mean, I definitely wouldn't mind getting the extra money to go out with my friends.
Yeah, that's good. Well, this has worked out in sports nowadays.
But if you want to get me, you know, some extra cash, I would not mind being paid to play the sport that I love.
All right, I'll see what I can do.
You know, thanks a lot, Doug, for coming out and seeing what I do for a little bit. But I really have a big chemistry test that I have to study for on Monday, and we got study tables in 10 minutes that I can't really miss as an athlete. Mm-hmm. So it was really nice to meet you.
Nice meeting you, too. Hope to see you again.
Dr. Emmert, New Orleans Noel is here to see you.
All right, please send him in. Thanks.
What's up, man?
Hey. Hey, New Orleans.
Yeah, man.
I'm Mark Emmert.
Mark Emmert, man. I didn't know that. I thought you were Doug.
I just wanted an undercover name. I had to see for myself how practices went and the hard work that you put in.
Yeah, man. That's cool, man. I appreciate it. Try hard out here.
Yeah, it is some hard work. And yeah. I hear you college athletes want pay for play.
Yeah, man. We do, man. You know, I feel like we work hard enough, man. You know, you seen that workout.
Yep. I understand all those reasons, believe me. Yeah. But sadly, we can't do it.
Dang, man, it sucks.
Remember the NCAA, we know all the reasons why, and it just won't happen. There's just too many results that's going to happen, decrease in competition. You guys already received the scholarship that you were talking about, and there's restrictions along with Title IX. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry, but we just can't do it. But what I can do, I can get you to Disneyland.
Disneyland?
Mm-hmm. Sound good?
Sounds great, man.
We have a circle deal?
We got a deal, man.
All right.
I'm going to Disneyland.
There you go.
All right, man. I'll see you later, man.
Come in.
You want to see me?
Yep. Hello, Al.
Hi.
I'm Mark Emmert.
I thought you were Doug.
Well, I was, but that was just my undercover name. Because the TV show you're talking about, the reality TV show, it's actually reality. It's me going undercover and seeing what it is like to be with college athletes around the world.
All right.
And while here at UK, you brought up some good points by working with others at the soccer fields and on the soccer team. And like I said, you brought up some good points with why college athletes should be paid. But I'm sorry, we can't do it.
If I understand.
For Title IX, like you said, if we paid the guys, we'd have to pay the girls, but we're not going to pay the guys either. Can't do that because of decreasing competition, scholarships you guys already receive, Title IX. Sorry.
That's all right.
But I do have a new deal for you. I can get you to Disney World. Does that sound like it would be pretty good?
I would be so happy. I've never been to Disney World before.
Do we have ourselves a deal?
Yes, thank you so much.
No problem. Hope to see you again.
It was nice meeting you.
Yep.
episode of The Undercover Boss, you saw Chief Executive Officer Mark Emmert go undercover and be transformed into Doug, a person pretending to film a reality television show about the day in the life of a college athlete. Doug met the outstanding Wildcat basketball star, Nerland Sewell, and ran through some of his daily basketball drills, as well as attempted to keep up with soccer star Alex Carter during her practice routines. Each of these two athletes had concerns about the controversial topic of paying college athletes. Nerland Sewell was trying to demonstrate his struggles of being a college athlete and not having enough money in his pocket to go out to lunch with Doug. Alex Carter, on the other hand, wanted to be paid. She just wanted to have that same payment that Nerland Sewell would be receiving. In the end, you saw that neither Nerland or Alex Carter would be able to be paid by the NCAA. Mark Emmert discussed a few of these reasons, such as decreasing competition and the fact that it would go against Title IX, and the knowledge that most of the scholarships already handed out to the athletes are payment enough for their time and dedication to the sport. First, if college athletes were to be paid, as Mark said earlier, it would decrease competition. This would happen because the bigger colleges who take in the most revenue would be able to pay the better athletes more money than the smaller colleges. If the smaller colleges could not afford to pay the top athletes, then there would be no chance of the smaller universities being able to compete with the bigger schools. Second, Mark discussed the scholarships that the college athletes are already being paid. These scholarships include room and board, tuition, and book fees. This is known as a full ride scholarship. The amount of money used for scholarships to allow the athletes to make it through college without having to pay for their fees is enough money for the athletes. They should not be paid extra just because they're the big names on campuses. Regular students are forced to find their own ways of paying college tuition and funds, and they're not granted enough extra money in order to be able to go out with friends on the weekends. Therefore, this is another reason why college athletes should not be paid. Lastly, when Alex brought up the topic of Title IX, she answered her own question as to why college athletes could not be paid. Title IX was a bill passed to the NCAA over 30 years ago that stated men and women should be treated equally and fairly throughout the different sports. No man could be receiving more than a woman could be receiving. This is one of the main reasons that college athletes cannot be paid. It is no surprise to anyone that men athletics produce more revenue than women athletics do as well as the fact that basketball and football athletics produce more revenue than the smaller sports of soccer, tennis, or baseball. However, it would be unfair to only pay men's basketball and football athletes and not pay everyone else in the industry. These three main topics are the primary reasons as to why college athletes cannot be paid, and it is why Mark Emmert was unable to provide payment to Nerland Sewell and Alex Carter. Fortunately for them, though, they're enjoying their time at Disney World.